Salutations, Celestial Sightseers. I'm David Fuller. Welcome to Eyes on the Sky. What's up this week? And now, a tale of two clusters. It was the best of globulars. It was the worst of globulars. Okay, in all seriousness, this is a video about two nearly identical globular clusters. Well, if they were placed side by side. Let's start with the further one. Looking to the south not long after dark, find the distinctive teapot asterism within the larger constellation of Sagittarius. At the lid of the teapot is the 2.8 magnitude star Caos Borealis, that is about 77 light years away. Seems pretty far, right? Well, 77 light years is pretty much within our stellar neighborhood, when you consider that the Milky Way galaxy is about 100,000 light years across. So, back of the envelope calculation, from us it's only about 0.08% the distance across the galaxy's diameter. So, that star's right next door, really, in cosmic terms. Near Caos Borealis, from our line-of-sight perspective, is an object much further away, the globular cluster Messier 28. It's pretty easy to find, less than 1 degree away from the star, so most any wide-field eyepiece can place the star and the cluster in the same field of view. Once you find it by spiraling around the star, you can center the cluster and give it a good look. With the brightest individual stars at 12th magnitude, a 114mm telescope, or larger, can begin to resolve a number of the globular stars. Now, this cluster is 100 light-years across, and is also almost 35,000 light-years away. Whoa! Yeah, so its total diameter is bigger than the distance from us to Caos Borealis, and from us 2M28 is nearly one-third that of our entire galaxy's diameter. Ponder that for a moment, and we'll look at another globular close by in a moment. And now this week's Dark Sky Fact. This week I'm asking you to make one change to your present lighting by changing a bulb, adding a shield, or just simply aiming your lights down. Please make that change this week. There will be links on the homepage of eyesonthesky.com to places that you can purchase items to help accomplish this. Thank you. Having looked at this average-ish so-so cluster and teasing out all the detail that you can, our next target is undoubtedly impressive by comparison, Messier 22. This is also near our top-of-the-teapot star, a little further away, but at just 2.5 degrees from it, you can place Caos Borealis at the edge of a finder scope field and have M22 centered, and you might even be able to see it in the finder scope. Just look for this little grouping of 5th, 6th, and 7th magnitude stars, the brightest of which is the K-class star 24 Sagittarii. Messier 22 is similar in many ways to Messier 28. They both generally lie in the same direction from us, and Messier 22 is also about 100 light-years across. But M22 is 3.3 times closer, which therefore makes it appear about 3 times larger, and consequently, at least that much more impressive even in small telescopes. Be sure to check out these two clusters before we lose them to the horizon in a month or two. Watch carefully what Venus is going to do over the next month or so as Saturn begins to drop towards the horizon, and Venus sort of makes a beeline sideways to the south. On the morning side, Mars struggles to gain much altitude above the horizon as Jupiter treks slowly through Gemini, joined by the Moon on the morning of August 31st. Later at night, Neptune is at opposition. Eyes on the Sky highlighted that planet just a few short weeks ago. And don't forget about Nova Delphini 2013. As of August 23rd, it was still hovering around magnitude 6. That's all for this week. Keep your eyes in the sky and your outdoor lights aimed down so we can all see what's up. I'm David Fuller, wishing you clear and dark skies.